Good morning, and welcome to First Presbyterian Church. We are glad that you are here. If you're worshiping with us at home, we are also glad that you are with us. You have choices, and we're glad that you chose to be with us this morning. I have a few announcements this morning. just want to remind everybody that we are thankful for the Presbyterian women. They are the heart of this church, and they make a big difference. So that's what makes this place a home for us. So thank you. We have information in the Reacher. We're doing a food drive to help fill up the Salvation Army's food pantry for the holidays. So you can bring, there's a list in the Reacher of what we need, and I'll put that on our Facebook page and our website later today. Bring those items and put them in the pantry or in our parlor, and we'll get those out in the next couple weeks. We have some prayer requests. We need to continue to hold up the Stevens family in our thoughts and prayers. They had a double organ transplant that they're going through. The Pettit family is still having health issues, so keep them in your thoughts and prayers. My brother Gene and sister-in-law Robin Martins are having health issues. My sister-in-law is battling leukemia, so they continue to struggle with that. The prayers are helping because she was on some medication, very expensive medication. It's like $50,000 a month, and they had her on some medication that did not work the first time, so they've been fiddling with it. They put her back on it. This time it's working. So from the Martins, I want to thank you for your thoughts and prayers. We need to continue to hold up Larry Fisher's sister in our thoughts. She's in a nursing home in Minnesota. And I want to report here, I talked to Larry this morning. After we put her on a prayer list and prayed for her, the next day she started to get much better. So prayers do help. Sometimes we don't notice it, but that is blessed news. So that's all that I have this morning. Thanks.
To lead us into truth, that we may be saved. A mighty fortress is our God.
Their iniquities, says the Lord, and remember their continues. God is not done with us. We are forgiven. Thanks be to God.
Having confessed our sins and been assured of our forgiveness, let us now read responsibly this passage from Jeremiah. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah.
It will not be like the covenant that I made with their ancestors, when I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, a covenant that they broke, though I was their husband, says the Lord.
But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people.
No longer shall they teach one another, or say to each other, Know the Lord, for they shall all know me, from least of them to the greatest, says the Lord. For I will forgive their iniquity, and remember their sin no more.
Tell the story of why we have the referendum. smiling on friends who pissed on my friends because they say, you can go back. Or something like that. But when in the olden church, when they worshiped, they always had incense, you know, which is myrrh and frankincense. Myrrh is death, frankincense is worship, and other spices mixed in with it, and it gave a pleasant fragrance to the Lord. So, when you're in worship, imagine inhaling a fragrance and inhaling the Lord. And then, of course, there's your mouth. All James says the mouth is a terrible thing because it can say good things and it can say bad things. It can gossip and it can tell the truth. It, misinformation, they call it now. You can pass information about your friends and pretty soon it will be known as truth. So watch your mouth, what you say, and what comes out of your lips. And when you get good news to tell, sing it, because the Lord loves singing, and we all do. The senses we don't talk about very often, this is what's terrific for the children, so shut up, Eleanor. One more thing, the senses we don't talk about go with your head and your heart and your gut. And respond to your brain with your head, with your heart, and with your gut. And respond to the Lord the same way. Thank you. Now, Dr. Listen to the word of the Lord. Beginning with Psalm 46. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear though the earth gives way, though the mountains be moved into the heart of the sea, though the waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble at its swelling. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God will help her when morning dawns. The nations rage, the kingdoms totter. He utters his voice. The earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Come, behold the works of the Lord, how he has brought desolations on the earth. He makes wars cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the chariots with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Selah. And from the book of Romans, chapter 3, verses 19 to 28. Now we know that whatever the law says, it speaks to those who are under the law, so that every mouth may be stopped and the whole world may be held accountable to God. For by works of the law, no human being will be justified in his sight, since through the law comes knowledge of sin. But now, the righteousness of God has been manifested apart from the law. Although the law and the prophets bear witness to it, the righteousness of God, through faith in Jesus Christ, for all who believe. For there is no distinction, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, and are justified by his grace as a gift, through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God put forward as a propitiation by his blood, to be received by faith. And this was to show God's righteousness, because in his divine forbearance he had passed over former sins. It was to show his righteousness at the present time, so that he might be just and the justifier of the one who has faith in Jesus. Then what becomes of our boasting? It is excluded. By what kind of law? By a law of works? No, but by the law of faith. For we hold that one is justified by faith apart from works of the law. And then from the Gospel of John, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, there it is, John chapter 8. Beginning with verse 31. So Jesus said to the Jews, who had believed him, if you abide in my word, you are truly my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. And they answered him, we're offspring of Abraham and have never been enslaved to anyone. How is it that you say you will become free? Jesus answered them, "Truly, truly, I say to you, everyone who practices sin is a slave to sin. The slave does not remain in the house forever. The Son remains forever. And if the Son sets you free, you will be free indeed." This ends the gospel. Amen.
Thank you.
serve a little bit and hear the law. From Isaiah chapter 50. Morning, my work, morning, God awakens my ear to hear as those who are taught. Psalm 94. God planted your ears, and he can hear you, and you can hear him. Psalm 40, verse 6. Hear with the ears God dug for you. When you read Psalm 40, and you get to that verse, follow the footnote. The Hebrew word is dug. He didn't just open your ears, he dug them. And then, as I said a second ago, he planted them. And then sacrifice and offering, God does not delight. He wants you to hear him. And he opens your ears. He wants you to hear him and obey him. He wants you to hear the music of the heavenlies. I have a coffee cup that says, God gave us music so that we could pray without singing, we could pray without words. And I think of that, being able to pray without words, being able to sing. Wake and listen to heaven's harmonies. Wake and hear revelation. He who has an ear to hear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches. Then from the Old Testament, Zechariah chapter 7. But the people refused to pay attention and turned a stubborn shoulder and plugged their ears. So they couldn't hear, didn't want to hear. Is that you? Have you turned your shoulder and plugged your ears? From your ears, you hear people. Have you ever sat silently with someone? Job says, be silent and sit. For 7 days, his friends sat beside him. They were waiting. From Ephesians, in him, when you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and believed, you were sealed because you heard it. From Psalm 119, how sweet are your words to my taste, sweeter than honey to my mouth. And I remember my tenor husband saying, sometimes when they worshiped and sang, the words were sweet and the choir could taste them. Jeremiah says he found God's words in Achan, and God's words were a joy and a delight to his heart. And then from James, is anyone suffering? Pray. If you're cheerful, sing. That seems so obvious to us. And from Exodus, after crossing the Red Sea, they all sang. And a woman led the singing, remember Mary? And the song was, I will sing to the Lord because he has triumphed gloriously. The Lord is our strength and our song. And psalms again, which are prayers and songs both. Your laws have been my songs in the house where I am staying. I will sing all my life. I will sing praises to God. And from 1 John, what was from the beginning, what we have heard, what we have seen, what we have looked at, what we have touched, concerning the word of life. The life was revealed, and we have seen and testified and proclaimed. And you are living stones being built in a spiritual house to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each one of us may receive what is due for what he's done, whether for good or for evil. What have you done with your lips, your speech, your song? What have you done with your ears? What have you heard that has immediately come out of your mouth? When you should have waited, perhaps. to listen, to hear you. Lord, we pray today for our sick, for our grieving, for our friends in nursing homes. We pray for the staff of those nursing homes. Father God, we pray for our state. We pray for our nation that seems to be divided into 10,000 fractions. Lord, enable us to come together. We pray for the Ukraine and Russia, that peace will come there. We can't see how, Lord. You know. And Lord, for the war that is attempting to destroy your people, the war that is attempting to permanently break the covenant that you have made with your people. Lord, only you and your angel armies can bring that to a peaceful conclusion. And Lord, if this war is of you, and it is part of your plan, Lord, as we face chaos here, enable us to be leaders. Lord, enable us individually and as a church body to pick up the hurting, to pick up the weeping. Enable us, Lord, to act Christianly with those who stand alone when all around them have fallen. Give us the gifts, Lord. May we ask for them. Give them to us. Lord, this is our prayer. And now we join, Lord, in a prayer that your only Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Thank you. to use in your will and in your way. May we be